Hello, upcoming students who are willing to apply for Germany. Good evening, everyone. Today here again I am. Welcome to my channel, Guide for German Application. So today I gathered all information how you can apply for Frederick Alexander University in Nuremberg. So here last winter I have applied for CME course, Communication and Multimedia Engineering. I got admission over there. But today I'm going to tell you how you can apply for the same course. So this is the very easiest method of applying I have ever seen in other colleges. So firstly, this is the web page. You have to click on master degree programs. After clicking master degree programs, there are three types of master degrees, which is first one is which is exclusively taught in English, which is partially taught in English and German, and last one is purely German. So you have to click on program taught in English. Here I have applied for two courses. When I applied in last winter, I applied for Communication and Multimedia Engineering and Advanced Signal Processing and Communication Engineering. I got rejection from Advanced Signal Processing, but I got acceptance from Communication and Multimedia. So I will guide you through how you can apply for Communication and Multimedia Engineering. If you click on that, so this is the course description. It says it's 4 semester and program starts on only winter semester. So if you click on more information, it will take you to Communication and Multimedia webpage. Here it shows who are all can eligible for apply: electrical engineering, communication engineer, computer science and applied mathematics and physics. So then you have to click on prospective students and apply, click on application. So this is the application procedure. This application procedure walks through two steps. In first step, you have to mail them with these many documents: your CV, your secondary like second PUC certificate and degree certificate, IELTS or TOEFL. Here I have mentioned in Stuttgart website, if you can remember, this Frederick Alexander University Nuremberg accept IELTS and medium of instruction also. And if you have GRE, you can send them, and certificate of English and German, like if you have completed A1 A2, you can just send. Recommendation letters also you can send, LOR, if you have, if any. You have to send these many documents to student this website. So before submitting, the first thing I mentioned here, you have to download this application form. This application form you have to fill. I will show my application which I have filled and submitted last winter. So this is my CME application which I have filled last winter. I just walk you through how it looks. So here the email which you have to send. Here you have to fill the basic details first for personal informations. You have to just fill personal information, and here itself you have to mention your Skype ID. This Skype ID, it will help after first step. After first step, you will be allowed to attend our interview, which interview will be around for 30 minutes. I will just talk about interview afterwards. So after that, you have to fill details about education. Here firstly you have to fill about PUC. I have filled PUC here, and you have to fill about engineering here. So as I mentioned, I applied with 6 semester last time, and if your GPA is less than 2, you will definitely pass the first step. After first step, you have to attend the interview. If you pass interview, you'll get admission. Then after education details, you are supposed to give SLC and PUC marks and all. Then after that, you have to give the prerequisites. These are the prerequisite. Which are the prerequisite you can ask? In Stuttgart website, you have uploaded a module handbook, if you can remember. In that, you have to cut and paste what are the major subjects you have mentioned. See here, they are asking you to specify the course you have completed in electrical engineering, like example analog circuits and all. This electrical engineering means these are like core modules. You will be studying these core modules from second year, which is purely electrical. You have to be very cautious. You have to mention only purely electrical and electronic subjects. Then in second part, they are asking you to apply like type your mathematical subjects. You can mention from M1 to M4. We had M1 to M4 four subjects. So I have mentioned all the four subjects which are I've studied. Then they're asking information and communication and multimedia technologies. This multimedia technologies comes under like programming, electrical magnetic field and microprocessor, microcontroller, which you have studied in your UG. You have to just mention them, the subjects and the subjects contents. After that, they are asking you to why you like feel you are a like successful UG programmer in electrical engineering. Then you have to mention if you have taken GRE, just mention you have taken and give marks. If you haven't, just mention not taken. So these are the internship and activities what you have done. You just have to write your internship. If you don't have, just fill it blank. Then again they'll ask for your languages. You just have to fill your languages. If you have completed your German also, just mention your German, which level you have completed. So after that they'll ask like this is the fees of their course, then how you can fill. You just have to mention then. So here recommendation letter, if you are mentioning, then you have to mention the people who are giving you the recommendation letter. So I got one from my college lecturer and one from my internship lecturer. So I have mentioned those two email IDs, name and phone number. After that, this statement of intent. What I have did is I just copied my SOP and pasted here. That makes you very easy. Then other qualification, you can just mention your what you can say achievements here, over here, achievements over here, and the further relevant information here. This part is very important. Relevant information is nothing but what are the projects you have made or papers publication into the communication and multimedia field itself. It should be relevant. So I have done four projects and I have published three or four papers and I have mentioned all that papers and all. After that, this is like statistical information. How you got to know this university, how you shortlisted it and why you have intent to study here. So I just mentioned how I got this college and how I get to know this course and all. After filling this, you are ready to go. It has 8 page. This is the first document which you have to submit over the application. So you are good to go with first application. This is the application form. You can just click on that download and that PDF will appear. You have to just edit it and send it. So with that PDF, you have to send your curriculum vitae, secondary school leaving certificate and TOEFL GRE recommendation letter you have. So here, before submitting, you have to save these files. For saving these files, they have mentioned a criteria. You have to just save with this name itself. If you click on this, they'll just show you how you have to save. See here, for application form, you have to save like this. CME01 application form, your family name and your first name. So it will like follows for everything. So CME2 for CV, CME3 for transcript universities, TOEFL, APS, German language, recommendation 1 and 2. So if you have any other certificates which you are submitting, you can just mention 1, x and xxs. X is nothing but like that certificate name. So they need TOEFL 779 and IELTS or other language. CME has not they don't have any minimum scores, so you can just submit with 6. They usually recommend to apply with B2. B2 comes under 6 to 6.5 if you have taken IELTS. If you don't have IELTS, you can just submit medium of instruction. So I just show you which I have like mailed long back. I just have to search that. Where has CME? See, this is my email which I have sent. So I have sent them with a subject name called application request for master program communication and multimedia. So I have applied and sent them my application form, my CV, my transcript and transcript of bachelor's. This transcript is nothing but third one, is nothing but my second PU mask card, and I have submitted my IELTS certificate and German certificate, and these are two recommendation letter which I have got from my college, and this is my internship certificate, this is my pursuing letter. Because I have sent my pursuing letter because I have applied based on my sixth sem mask card. I haven't finished my degree at that time, that's why I have applied through my pursuing letter. And you can just mention the achievement certificate and complete module handbook and passport. These are the three extra documents that I have uploaded for them. So after that, after sending them a mail, I got a reply that they'll tell you the result earliest of March. So after around 8 to 9 weeks, I got a mail from them regarding my CME interview. Here I got it on April 9th. So my interview was on April 16th, and they have mentioned the time here. They have only given the fundamentals, which are the topics I need to go through. These are the topics which I have got: mathematics, electronics, stochastic process and linear system theory, and signal system and communication. But they have covered all topics, but major questions was from systems, signals and systems. So if you can ask me how was the interview, like I can just tell you that it will cover all three formats, like easy, intermediate and tough. But most of the questions are intermediate. If you are well good and well versed and well prepared, you can just crack that interview. After your interview, they'll announce results after interview. Like it will take around 1 week. If you are very good, they'll announce your results. So this is the complete procedure which you'll have to go through for communication and multimedia. So same procedure holds good for AAC course also. You just have to mail them with regarding this, and you'll get a interview mail, and you have to attend the interview. So thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. So in upcoming videos, I'm thinking I can make a video on Hochschule Bremen and TU Darmstadt and Darmstadt University of Applied Science and so on. So if you are finding any difficulties in any other colleges, you can just mention in comment box. So thank you for watching this video. Thank you so much.